Middle Ages, there was a recorded widespread psychiatric disorder that caused people to believe that they were made of glass. People afflicted with the fear lived in terror of shattering to pieces at any minute. King Charles VI of France was famously so afflicted by this preoccupation that he refused to allow people to touch him out of fear that he would shatter. He also supposedly wore special protective clothing. The glass delusion was so prevalent that it was mentioned in the works of famous authors like Miguel de Cervantes, Constantine Huygens, René Descartes, and John Locke.
Okay then, you learn something new every day, don't ya? The glass delusion? Maybe it was just because people were like super frail back then and they could just like slip and fall and like break a bone. They're like, oh no, I'm like made of glass. Maybe they literally just have like a, what is it? There's people that like bruise really easily. There's people that can break bones really easy. Maybe that was just them. They're like, oh my God, what if I'm just like made of glass? Can you guys see right through me? That's trippy though, that's really trippy.
In the spring of 1954, more than 3,000 windshields in the Seattle area experienced mysterious unexplained pitting. Police initially blamed the blemishes on vandals. However, the pitting became so widespread that it became clear no criminal could work quite so swiftly. It wasn't long before reports of the pitting hit the mainstream news. A number of theories were floated around that spring. One was that the nearby Jim Creek Naval Radio Station was producing waves with a new million-watt radio transmitter that was powerful enough to impact the physical properties of glass.
So, I must seem super real quick, but when he says pitting, does that mean just like damage, cracking? Is that like a British word? Is he even British? I don't know. Is that a British word? Pitting? Windshield pitting? Never heard of that term ever. I think like windshields were cracking. Maybe they were just using fragile glass. Like a bunch of cars probably needed to be recalled. They're like, oh my bad, we made your windshield wrong. And then people are like, oh my God, why are people getting freaked out about windshields cracking? They're like, oh my God, this company is sending scary radio waves and it's breaking the glass. Oh, you hear that? Breaking the glass. I don't know, man. It's not that scary, though.
Engineers advised NASA to postpone the launch of the Space Shuttle Challenger due to concerns about the O-rings and the solid rocket boosters at low temperatures. They were overruled, largely because the next launch window wasn't on a school day, and having students watch the first teacher launch to space was a big PR goal. As everyone knows, that launch failed because an O-ring in one of the SRBs failed. The organizational behavior was astounding. Basically managers overriding scientists who knew the O-rings must have a temperature limit because they knew they failed more when it was cold. But they did not have complete data because they had never failed completely and could not tell bosses what the limit was.
So literally, this whole rocket crash happened because people were like, oh, but it's gonna be a good PR stunt. People could die or it could be successful, even though the scientists were like, no, postpone it. Postpone it. And NASA was just like, oh, what? We're gonna continue on? Cool. Gather all the students and teachers. And now everyone's traumatized after they saw that.
Time, an organization funded by the US government, deliberately withheld syphilis treatments from black men for 40 years in an attempt to see how the disease would progress.
Disgusting.
Despite the fact that a cure was readily available? Oh, and how it continued until 1972. The government also told a group of black men they had syphilis so they could use them as a control group. When one of their controls actually caught syphilis, they would just switch them to the unmedicated group.
What the frick is wrong with our government? With our government, sorry, I'm not from the US. What is wrong with society? Honestly, all governments are pretty sketchy. They have done some sketchy things. This is unbelievable. Why aren't people talking about this more? They literally had treatment and they're like, no, we're just gonna observe you guys as if you're like test subjects, test animals. That is literally crazy. What if they're like running tests on us right now? Bro, what if we're the next test subjects?
London genocide, it lasted 4 months. 1,070,014 people dead in 100 days. That's 10,700 people killed per day. 446 people per hour. 7.4 people killed per minute. In an area that's 394 square miles larger than Maryland, 4 people in every 28 were murdered between April and July. That's about 72.6% of the Tutsi population. The most important thing to note about this is it happened in the 1990s. No one seems to know about it, which is totally not on purpose, right?
So I learned about this in high school. It's absolutely crazy. It just blows my mind. You know what's crazy is I never knew that it happened in the 1990s, like so recently. That's pretty recent for me. Like, you know, it's not like the 1960s. That is insane. 7.4 people killed per minute. 0.4. How do you kill 0.4 of a person? Anyways, it's crazy. And you guys need to do some research on it.
Franklin expedition in 1845 to find the Northern Passage, which would be a faster route when traveling and trading cargo across the Northern Hemisphere to Asia and China. The ships got caught in the ice and therefore stuck there forever. The crew turned to cannibalism as a way to survive in the cold and stayed on the lower decks of the ships, where they'd eventually get very sick because of malnourishment. One of the ships were named Terror. Ironically, there's a book about it which of course puts in some supernatural elements to the story. I however think the real story is creepy in its own right. Imagine being stuck in the ice, it's cold as hell everywhere, there's no food left and the nights are very dark.
Yeah, and then when they did find the bodies, they looked absolutely horrifying. Obviously they were like frozen, so they were like perfectly preserved, and I've seen photos of them. We're not allowed to show, but I've seen the photos of them and it is terrifying. Like their frozen face like is like, ah.
This in turn caused a tsunami in the Bay of Naples, and ash rained down on nearby cities. The volcano later released pyroclastic flows, which are essentially 18,000 degree Fahrenheit clouds of gas and volcanic matter that can travel upwards of 400 miles per hour.
This distinct layer of solidified ash is evidence of a high-speed current of heated gas and volcanic debris. Known as a pyroclastic flow,
the flows decimated the nearby cities and killed people instantly, vaporizing their blood and organs.
Vaporizing their blood and organs? Dude! You're like trying to escape, then all of a sudden like, pfft. Ah! Like literally into vapor, your organs, your blood, like blood's a liquid, man. But like your organ, that's like solid human tissue. It's like, pfft. Done. I don't know what event this was, it didn't say. It was just like pyroclastic, plastic? I don't know what event that was, but it's spooky.
Battle of Waterloo proved especially fruitful for the denture market, and the resulting products became known as Waterloo teeth. Battlegrounds were also looted for bones after the dead had decomposed, and these bones were ground into dust and sold to farmers.
What?
A British paper from 1822 reported that human bone made for, quote, substantial manure.
So they just went around picking up people's bones, grounding it up, and they mix it with the dirt, and they're like, this makes good manure. How did they figure that out? It's like somebody literally was just like, hey, you guys gonna take those bones? Are they free? Who's got dibs on the bones? Can I take it? Collected them all, mashed them up, and was just like, what can we do with it? Okay, let's just put it back in the ground. No, those people are psycho. Whoever thought about that? Like, no one thinks, I'm gonna take some bones and like smash it up, make it into a dust or whatever, and mix it with dirt and then use it as manure. No one thinks of that. People were having fun with the bones and then they wanted to get rid of it, so they tossed it in the dirt and they're like, actually, we should just do this more often.
Due to the southern heat, they buried her very quickly. Soon after her death, however, other locals seemingly showed similar symptoms, only to recover. The culprit, retrospectively, was likely encephalitis. Locals promptly dug up Hatcher's grave and realized that she didn't die, but had fallen into a coma. They found evidence of her having woken up, including scratches on the coffin and Hatcher's bloody nails. The veracity of the story has been questioned, but according to a member of Big Sandy Heritage Center's board of directors, quote, most local historians do agree that Hatcher did fall ill and was buried alive.
Well, that's traumatizing. I personally don't have a fear of being buried alive, but that does sound really scary. Can you imagine? She wakes up and she's like in a coffin, trying to scratch her way out, and then she just like dies of suffocation or malnutrition, whatever, lack of food and water. One of those things would take her. But like, oh, can you imagine opening it up and like seeing her try, like that's how I imagine she passed away, just like frozen like this. That is absolutely terrifying. And I've heard about this in history. I don't know if it was called like the sleep plague or something like that, but they were like eating a tea that was infused with something and it was causing them to slip into a coma or just fall asleep. And the people were like, oh, oh, I don't know if I can swear on this channel. They're like, oh, they're dead. But meanwhile, they were still alive and their pulse was like just really faint. And that's why people in the morgue couldn't tell if they were like alive or not, because their pulse was like really low.
The negative environment Zimbardo chose to test his ideas was a prison. He would convert the
Stanford prison experiment
into a subterranean.
I'm smart.
The experiment quickly flew off the rails, with some of the guard students veering into psychological torture by enacting extreme measures, including psychological abuse and harassment. That said, the experiment's methodology is extremely contentious, as it had repeatedly been compromised by Zimbardo's goading. Some of the prisoners also knew the study's hypothesis and acted accordingly, which is an unwanted variable in psychological experiments called demand characteristics.
Yeah, this is crazy. I've heard about it. I've done papers on it. Blah, blah, blah. Basically, he had like two sets of student, like volunteer students, and he's just like, you guys are gonna be the prisoners, you guys are gonna be the guards, and just like let them go. The freaking guards were like doing some mean stuff to the prisoners to the point where he had to cut the experiment like short. Like I think it only lasted 3 days because they were like torturing them and like saying mean things to them. And the prisoners were actually getting really depressed and got messed up from this experiment. So it's crazy. Meanwhile, they were just acting and then this happened. I don't know, it's crazy. There's a documentary on it on Netflix if you want to check it out, Stanford Prison Experiment. There you go. All right guys, that's all for today's video. If you want to see a part two, then you gotta let me know in the comments below, and also smash that like button. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I'll see you when I see you. Stay spooky. Okay. Hold on. Okay. Bro, this is, also I say bro too much. I got caught in the last thing. There's like a compilation of me being like, bro, bro. Anyway, we're not gonna say bro anymore. I just said it again. Anyway, let's go on, bro. False start. 7.4, oh, I was reading the statistic. Go research in history. Go research in history. All right, guys, that's all for today's video. If you want to see part, what part was that? Or is that the first one?
That's the first one.
Nice. All right.